Hi everyone. In loom knitting, people often say the solution to a curling edge is making a slip stitch. But some yarn will still curl then. So it's a solution, but it's not the solution. When you are only knitting a knit stitch, like E-wrap, or true knit, U-wrap, or flat knit, the four knit stitches in loom knitting, your fabric will curl. This is because, and I will cut a long story real short, because all the stitches are heading into the same direction. One of the solutions is to change the direction of the knit stitch with a purl stitch on both sides, or a combination between a purl stitch and a knit stitch, so a garter stitch or a rib stitch or a seed stitch. By changing the stitch pattern at the beginning at end of each row, it stabilizes the fabric and you have a nice edge for seaming, or you have a nice finished edge. And I will show you. I have been studying a bit, and as you can see, I have made some examples. You see this yarn? Yeah, I even have make edges, but even with selvages it curls a bit, but it won't curl as much as this one, as you can see. So this is a true knit and you see it curls, and with a selvage it won't curl that much. This is a selvage with a double garter stitch. This is a selvage making a simple garter stitch. This is a chain slipped selvage. And okay, I'll show you how it looks when it's done with other yarn. So this is the double garter stitch selvage, and here is one done with other yarn, and you see when it's becoming a cowl it won't curl that much. So this is the simple garter stitch selvage, and this is with other yarn, and you can see it doesn't curl at all. This is a chain slipped selvage, and with other yarn, yeah, it does slightly curl, but it is less than not doing a slip stitch. This is when you do a slip stitch and then a purl stitch, and as you can see it's a nice edge. And this is how it looks when you make a cowl out of it. It still has a little bit of curling, but if I hadn't done that, it would have been curling like this. Okay, and then we have a picot selvage, and then you get a nice edge, which you can even use for the outside, of course. And this is how that looks with different yarn. So this is how it looks with this yarn, and this with that yarn. And why is there a phenomenon like self-edges or selvages? When you search the internet, you will find the answer. Most of the time, people, when they needle knit, they use selvages to create a clean or better looking edge. And also they use it to sew or seam the project together. It's looking more beautiful, or you get a better sight at your edge when you're making a cardigan or something like that. So the two parts of the cardigan, the front parts, will have a nice looking edge, a clean edge. So that is why people use a slip stitch or a self edge. And also you can use it with cowls or scarves. It doesn't matter at all, as long as it looks like you want it to look. I'm going to demonstrate in 5 videos how you do those self edges. So this is the introduction, and the other videos will be on this channel too. Hope to see you there. Bye bye.